Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today we have a question sent in by Giovanni. This is going to be tough. Let's see if we can get through the whole thing today. Giovanni wants to set up a quiz. He has a list of 25 definitions and the matching terms. He'd like to present a definition and four of the terms kind of in a quiz format. So I'm going to come over here to the right-hand side and see if we can build this on the fly. First thing we have to do is choose which of the 25 questions we're going to present first. So I'm going to use the RANDBETWEEN function. Ran between 1 and 25. Now, of course, if you're using Excel 2003, you have to use Tools, Add-ins, and choose the Analysis Toolpak before this would work. Basically, so that's going to be the definition we're going to present. And then the term, one of the four terms that we offer has to be the exact same number. So that one's easy. But for the other items, I want to kind of randomly choose, but I want to make sure there are no duplicates. And I don't want to have the right answer in there twice. That would be horrible. So I'm going to use the right answer plus a RAND between, say, 1 and 5. Now, there's a possibility that if the question we're asking about is later in the list, so for example, we're asking about item 20, then we might have item 22, 24, 27, and that's beyond 25. So the first thing I did is I took Giovanni's 25 line items and I copied them down so that way they run in rows 26 through 50, basically. So what's going to happen here is we're going to offer four different answers, and we can use the index function, equal index. We'll go back to the original terms, and I'll include the extra 25. I'll use the F4 key there and say that I want the second item. So these are the set of answers that we're going to give for this particular question. The question, again, we'll use the index there, so we'll use the equal index. This time, I'll go back to the definitions, and again, include the extra 50, hit the F4 key, and I'll use my random question as the index number. So now I have the definition. Now, the last thing that when I got to this point, I realized, well, wait a second, pretty soon people are going to realize that the right answer always comes first, and the bad answers come after that. So we need some way to randomize that. Now I'm going to go back. This is a tip that's in the book, Learn Excel from Mr. Excel. Basically, I'm going to add a new column here with a random number. So we'll use equal rand, and then I'm going to rank those random numbers. So we'll use equal rank of this random number within this whole set of random numbers. And the beautiful thing about that is that it's going to give me a number from 1 to 4, and it's going to be random every time. So when I set up my quiz, I'm now going to say, instead of just giving me these items in their exact order, I'm going to use an equal VLOOKUP. So that I want to find the number 1. Rather than write the number 1 here, though, I'm going to put the row of A1. That's an easy way to say 1. And look within this range, starting with my rank, over 5 columns. I want the 5th column and false. Now the beautiful thing about using row of A1 is that as I copy that down to the other items, it'll give me the row of A2, row of A3, row of A4. So the way that this works here, we've chosen question 17, the amount of time. We've chosen four answers, one of which is right, three of which are incorrect. But then because of the rank situation over here, we've said that we're going to put the correct answer as the second answer, basically answer B, and then the bad answers is A, C, and D. And down here I use VLOOKUPs to produce that quiz. Every time we hit F9 to calculate, we get a new question, new set of answers. So what sounded like a very easy thing to do for Giovanni required a lot of different techniques, using some RANDBETWEEN as we might have expected to choose the random items, but then also to make sure that we have no duplicates and that the answers are presented in a random sequence. I used another RAND function, as well as the rank function and a VLOOKUP. Wow, what a complicated thing to do for a Monday. But anyway, hopefully there's a few tips in there that will help you out, or if you need to build a quiz, just go back through the whole thing. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.